वरकातुहू स्टूडेंट्स फॉर टुडे विल बी डूइंग योर समेटिव असेसमेंट रिवीजन पार्ट 10 फॉर टुडे विल बी लर्निंग डिस्कोर्सेस माइनर डिस्कोर्सेस दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन योर क्लास सो वंस अगेन आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू ऑल द फॉर्मेट ऑफ पोस्टर एंड डायरी एंट्री ओके नाउ फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड हाउ वी राइट अ डायरी एंट्री एंड व्हाई डू वी राइट अ डायरी एंट्री So, many of us have this habit to maintain a journal, okay, maintain a journal for what happened or what we have experienced in a whole day. To write this or to maintain a written record about your feelings or your experiences in a day, we write a diary entry. So, how do we write a diary entry? So, diary entry always starts with date and day. Suppose today's date is XYZ March 2021 and whereas day is say some Wednesday or Thursday or Friday respectively. Now fine, this time is say optional. Time is optional. Either you can write it or you can avoid it. Now salutation. Always start with a salutation. Dear diary. Start it by saying dear diary. Now After writing your diary, you need to start your body or content. So here, in this part, you describe your feelings or your experiences or whatever you want to express, your thoughts or your opinions in the world. You should always start that. What was your experiences? Starting with a light note, you should not always jump into the conclusions or you should not always jump with the matter that has been or you have witnessed and it was horrible or good. Always start with a light note saying that today it was today the day started on a good note. It was pretty nice. It was a pretty, I witnessed a pretty sunshine. So these are always start your content or body of a diary with a light note, then you can come across or you can go what you want to express. After expressing your feelings or your thoughts, you can always conclude. You need to always conclude that with this I remain. With this I remain. Putting a comma just after that and at last you need to either do your signature or you need to write your name. So this format is followed by for your diary entry. Now, jumping up to the next topic, that is poster. So this poster, you must have seen in multiple arenas, okay? Posters are not only used by your school organizations, but posters are widely used by your business organization, by industrial organization, by government, by public sector, by private sector. So this poster is one similar thing that is common in each and every sector. Now, poster is nothing but this is a graphical representation of the matter that you want to say or you want to express. Okay? So this is a graphical representation of your thoughts that you want to express. Okay? Now, poster always starts with the title. Title in the sense, what is the poster about? Now, second one is presenter. Presenter means the one who is presenting it. May say your school is presenting a poster. Say your school is presenting a poster. Okay, so you're going to write your school name. Now, as I said you, the poster is all about graphical representation. So graphic are necessary whenever you're doing a poster. Graphics is necessary. Why? Because poster is all about graphical representation and your graphics should be as clear as your words. Okay, whatever graphics you're drawing or you're doing, it should be as clear as your words. By seeing the graphics, you need to understand what is the poster about and whatever you're trying to express. Later on, you can conclude some, you can write some content, say proverb, or say some idiom, or say some wise words according to your poster. Now, you can always give some references for the poster, and also you need to give conclusion, okay? That what is this poster about and what you would like to conclude at last. So this was your poster, format of your poster. So always you need to follow this format whenever you are preparing a poster, and you need to follow this format whenever you are writing a diary entry. Hope you all have understood. I shall continue in the next class. Allah Hafiz.